गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ मॉरल साइंस। वी आर लर्निंग फ्रॉम द बुक पर्ल्स एंड पेटल्स। आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ आवर मॉरल साइंस, दैट इज पर्सनैलिटी। पर्सनैलिटी, वॉट इज पर्सनैलिटी? दैट वॉट यू आर एंड वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू बी, that is known as the personality. Man's main task in life is to give birth to himself, to become what he potentially is. The most important product of this effort is his own, that is a personality. A great effort is paid by the persons for formation of the personality. There are various types of personalities. People are characterized by the way they are showing their behavior towards the people, and that their behavior themselves consider the personality of the people. The quest for personality is as old as man. There was a time when personality was considered to be like a dress that one could put on. It was because personality was judged according to the external appearance of a person. Now we know that the term personality refers to developed self and is not a skin deep affair. So, in simple term, personality means what the way we are behaving towards the other people. That inner development of ours is known as the personality, and it is not a skin deep affair. In an experiment conducted by Paul R. Wilson in 1968, a guest lecturer was introduced to drive to five groups of Australian college students. Each group was told that he had a different academic status. In one group, he was introduced as a professor of psychology at Cambridge. In the second group, as a senior lecturer, a position with a lower status than the professor, then a lecturer, a demonstrator, and finally a student. So that was a five role played by the same person. First he was a professor, then he became the senior lecturer, and in the third form he became a lecturer, not also senior. And then the next, a demonstrator who demonstrate the things, the examples, and the last role he played was a student. So he formed five roles before the student of Cambridge. After the introduction, the students in each group were asked to estimate the height of the guest lecturer as well as the height of the regular class instructor, a person who had the same status in each of the five groups. Wilson found that the greater the ascribed status of the person, the taller he was judged to be. In fact, the professor of psychology at Cambridge was rated a full 2.5 inches taller than the student. In art, the basic unit to measure the human figure is the head. Accordingly, an average person is generally 7.5 head tall, including the head. An ideal figure used when aiming for an impression of nobility or grace is drawn at 8 heads tall. To depict a heroic figure, such as gods and superheroes, the height used is 8.5 heads length. People often develop a general impression of a person on the basis of minimal information. It says that generally people are having a habit, by getting the small information about someone, they start judging the person. It is common to misinterpret a person's personality merely in terms of its structural makeup. Some of the time we also had seen some people are coming from front. By seeing their outer side physical appearance, we start judging the personality of the person. That is totally wrong thing. Accordingly, a man with a handsome figure and a female with a beautiful, charming appearance are considered as person with sound personality. But maybe after talking to them, we can understand that their personality is nothing. So personality must not be judged by the physical appearance of the person. With the physical appearance, we have to challenge the inner appearance of the person so that we can describe the personality of a person. Personality means it is to a man what perfume is to a flower. Definitely, without the perfume, flower is not us. Same way, without a personality, a man cannot be us by the people. It is said by Charles M. Schwab. Personality is a unique combination of all the traits in a person: intellectual, spiritual, mental, cultural, and physical. It is a sum total of the component trait that make one a balanced person. The complete picture of a balanced personality includes factors such as his physical appearance, intellectual abilities, emotional reactivity, thought, attitudes, beliefs, choice, and value. This all things what I said, this all forms the character of a person that result in a typical behavior pattern. Depending on the unique combination of the various traits, we describe people using terms like charming personality, dynamic personality, charismatic personality, electrifying personality, and so on. The next is the components of personality, the parts of the personality. An individual's personality traits are formed quite early in life. There are three components that help form a child's personality. The very first is temperament, second is environment, and the third is character. Temperament. It is a set of genetically determined traits that determine the child's approach to the world and how he learns about the world. Environment. A child's specific environment can be manipulated to get the desirable positive effects in shaping the personality. The next is the character. It refers to a set of cognitive, emotional, and behavior patterns that determine how a person thinks, feels, and behaves. So these are the three things which helps to form a personality. The very first thing is temperament. Temperament shows that how the way we react to the situation which is before us. That way we can determine the child's approach to the world. And the second is environment. There are various types of environment around different peoples. Some are getting good and some are getting bad. Under that environment, how a child's specific environment can be manipulated to make a positive. Then the character, that is inner quality of a person. Emotional behavior pattern, that also helps to form the personality. Now we will start the topic, personality types. The personality types are grouping be developed on the basis of temperament of people. They were first developed by Hippocrates 2400 years ago. He divided personality into groups of four types. So what types we will be going to learn, it is according to Hippocrates 2400 years ago. Sanguine personality. I said sanguine personality. A person with a sanguine personality has a cheerful, hopeful disposition. Such persons are optimistic, confident, fun-loving, and popular. This type of person are considered as sanguine personality. They can easily get along well with people. Sanguine people usually have a lot of energy and can get others excited about the issues. However, they have a problem finding a way to direct their energy. They may promise but fail to deliver, and so cannot always be relied upon to get things done. There are the social types and are best at talking. So people get attracted towards sanguine personality people. Melancholic personality. The second category of personality is melancholic. A melancholic person is somberly thoughtful and excessively gloomy. Their behavior involves thinking, as they are thoughtful, assessing, planning, evaluating, and analyzing facts. It means they are busy in the thoughts. They make sure things happen. Sometimes they tend to paralyze themselves with over-evaluation. Melancholic types of persons are very creative and can be successful poets and artists. Being the mental type, they become preoccupied with the tragedy and cruelty in the world and so tend to become depressed. So these type of people who are totally based on thoughts, what they are desired, and they try to fulfill the thoughts, they are become many of the time depressed because they are not, because of the some tragedies and cruelty happen to them. Choleric personality. The third personality type is choleric. A choleric person is generally a dour type and possess leadership quality. Means the person who want to dominate others and want to become the leader. People belonging to this personality group are goal-oriented and focused on getting things done. The choleric disposition makes them strong, dominant, dense, unemotional, stubborn, and even arrogant. Arrogant at the moment when people are not doing the work according to them. They are ambitious, energetic, and passionate people. They always having some desire. They want to fulfill their desire, however, and are able to instill the same qualities in others. They want the same quality what they are having to be in others. Their enthusiasm to get things can make them angry, irritable, and impatient. The next quality person is phlegmatic personality. The phlegmatic personality. A person with a phlegmatic disposition is not easily excited to action or display of emotion. They are self-possessed, calm, unruffled, and quiet. Such people are uninterested in issues and do not confront people, and their indifference may cause frustrations. They generally resist change and avoid taking decisions. They are kind, self-contained, and lazy. They are a lazy kind of watchers who ensure that the status quo is maintained. The next, beside this four, the last category is the dispersonality styles. Psychologists in recent times have come up with a more modern understanding of personality called DISC personality styles. DISC stands for direct, influential, steady, and cautious. Direct. Direct means dominant and decisive. How you respond to problems and challenges. Influential, optimistic, and outgoing. How you influence others to your point of view. The next is a steady, sympathetic, and cooperative. How you respond to the pace of the environment. And the last is cautious, concerned, and correct. How you respond to rules and procedures set by others. So this type of personality person are known as DISC personality style. Now let us see some direct personality, then the influential. Direct personality, when we are talking, what all characteristics forms a direct personality person? For fast-paced and busy person, always busy in their work, prefer to do things by themselves and so do not like to delegate work. They themselves do all their work and they don't want to delegate the work with the others people. Not a team player. Got annoyed when others do things differently from the chosen way. Will fight for you and protect you. So goal-oriented that they don't bother about other people's ideas and feelings. Want straight talk and straight answer. Ask what type of questions. Generally, if you will find that type of people, they are considered as direct personality peoples. The second is influential personality. Influential people have the following characteristics: fast-paced, energetic, and usually busy. Like people and have a network of contacts. They are having lot of contacts with other people. Good at promoting ideas and persuade others to agree with them. More interested in people than in accomplishing tasks. Are optimistic and so can be poor judge of people. Communicate well, need freedom of expression. May overuse praise. It may be seen as flattery. Have trouble staying focused. Are imaginative and innovative. And ask generally who type of questions. Generally these people ask the questions like who. The next is the steady characteristics. Steady personality. Steady people have the following characteristics. Have a consistent work performance, like to maintain their environment, flexible in attitudes and accommodate others, moderate, modest and controlled, like to help others, are good listeners and counselors, need help in starting a project, like to have written things to refer to, they ask and not tell, ask how and when type of questions. So whatever people you will be getting and having this type of character are considered as steady personality. They don't want to change with the people. They want their attitude and they want to be with themselves. Cautious personality. Cautious persons have these characteristics are critical thinkers. Base actions on facts, the rules and accuracy. Slow paced and task oriented. Combine intuition, with facts to reach a conclusion. They always are thoughtful and they want to match their intuitions, whatever coming in their mind, with the reality. Like to keep peace, aggressive people upset them. Study a subject before discussing in public. Hide their feelings and protect their privacy. Start a project only when sure of perfection. Critical of themselves, defend and support their position, then show flexibility. Think things in sequence and make to-do list. Generally, this type of people ask the question why and how type of questions. So these were the four personalities of people, that was direct personality, influential personality, study personality, and cautious personality. Beside this, the last topic of the chapter is tips to develop a positive personality. May I think all the people want to develop a positive personality which is liked by all. So let us see what the tips we can have to develop a positive type of personality which is liked by many. If you want something you have never had, you must be willing to do something you have never done before. Thomas Jefferson. Very first thing what you have to do for making a positive personality is know yourself. First you have to understand yourself completely, then only discuss about others. So that way we can have the positive personality. Personality is the development of oneself in order to develop yourself. So know your own special traits, your weaknesses, your flaw, then come out with others. Second way is practice honesty, sincerity, and integrity. If you want to develop a positive personality, so the second thing what you have to develop is be honest, not only with others but with yourself. When your soul will be happy that you are honest, not only to others but also with yourself, then definitely positive personality will develop inside you. Sincerity must be there and integrity must be there. Adopt straightforward conduct and speech. Strive to fulfill promises. Be free from disgust and false pretenses. The third way to get positive personality is be positive in thought, word, and action. There are many times negativity comes to our mind. That negativity must be removed from our mind. We have to bring some positive thoughts that will be good for us and for others. First, we have to accept that positive thoughts for ourselves, then words, and then action. Put positive interpretation on people's behavior. If you start with positive assumption, you have a better chance of building a pleasing personality. The fourth way is acquire knowledge. Knowledge is power. It begets confidence, ignores begets fear, and fear leads to disaster. Read widely and wisely with a purpose. Improve your power of observation and retention. Then you will develop the knowledge which is needed to help others and to help yourself. That way you can develop the personality. Reinforce your scientific temperament and specialize on selected areas of interest and utility. The next is mind your etiquette and body language. Very important. Good manners and etiquette go a long way to make lasting impression on others. Your body language tells much about your personality. So wherever you will be going, whatever you will be doing, your body language must be like that people like that. Manners and mannerism reflect your mind more than your own words. The next thing you have to bring for the positive personality is smile and be kind. To develop a positive personality, the person must have a smile on the face that brings happiness in others and must be kind to others. A smile is contagious and it is an inexpressive way of showing kindness. Accept the responsibility. The next character for positive personality is accept the responsibility. Acceptance of responsibility is a mark of an authentic personality. It reflects your attitude and environment in which you operate. It is easy to make credit for what is right, but difficult to own up responsibility for what goes wrong. Do not shift the blame onto others. Be noble, own up responsibility. Next is be a good listener. The next feature for positive personality is the person must be a good listener. Sometimes we see many people are there, just speak about themselves. They don't stop and listen to others. That is totally a negative personality. We must be a good listener. Not only we have to speak, but also have a quality of listening. Listening is half the conversation. How would you feel if someone you are talking to does not listen? You will indeed feel delighted, neglected, let down, ignored, and so on. Won't do that for others. Choose your words carefully. There are different ways of expressing the things. The words by which we are expressing our feelings and emotion, that must be careful. Words have the power to make people feel confident and cheerful. You must use tact and prudence while speaking to others. Words reflect your attitude. Improve your choice of words can hurt and destroy. So improper choice of words must not be used. Think before you speak, talk less, say more. Don't speak if any are angry. The last thing what you have to do is involve in helping others. Social service is the quickest way out to develop personality. Helping others give you opportunities for self-expression. Social service help you to discover the finest qualities you possess, like kindness, selflessness, sacrifice, tolerance, leadership, etc. Community service gives you opportunities to serve and learn. Serve your neighbor and you will learn how to lead the nation. So that was the chapter personality. You have to prepare the notes, you have to read the chapter, and then you have to prepare the notes, and you can send the notes through the WhatsApp. Thank you.